I can't give this 100% on the cut quality. It's definitely good.
Before you say that.
Wonder friends. What's going on, everybody? Welcome.
Hold on. And three, two.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to this episode of G4 Outdoors. Today we're going to be doing a mowing review with the Toro Super Recycler with the 7.25 horsepower engine and the personal pace.
Dream of fishing while I'm going through my workday.
Okay, so I do have an unboxing video on this showing all of the parts on here, all the cool accessories, but I'm going to quickly go over any all of this, and if you're missing out on anything, just go back and hit this video up here because everything's in that video. So first off, we have the personal pace, and this is an excellent system. It's probably, well, it is my favorite system for self-propelled mowers. I don't know if I can call it the best because that is an opinion, but it is my favorite. We do have the stowable position in this, and without the bag on here, of course, this will store easily in your garage. Nice feature there, and it will not spill your oil or your gas. Put this back up into mowing mode. And also down here we have Flex. There are just little rubber grommets down here, and what that does is isolates the vibration from the mower up to the handles. Up here we do have oil. This is a no oil change mower. I don't know how they get by with that, but they do. Easy to change air filter up here, and your deck height adjustments, check this out. That's 1.5 inches. And that's just on the front. If I lowered these backs, you would see how actual low that is. And it does go all the way back up to 4 inches. And these are adjusted just like most lawn mowers. So on this yard right here, we're gonna drop it down just one notch, and then we're gonna cut this yard. Here on the side, you do have a gate for mulching, and these do have safety locks on them, so these are not gonna fall off or anything like that. Pull this lid up, slap on your grass flap, and now you can side discharge. If you don't want a side discharge and you want a bag, close that, lock it, and right back here on the back, you're going to have your opening for your bagger. I do have that piece uninstalled right now, but when it comes to bagging, it's just as easy as taking your bag, slapping it on here into the designated slots, and we're ready to bag. So that's just a quick overview on this. Now let's get into mowing. Okay, so on these mowers, they do have a start guarantee. In my unboxing video, I was very surprised about this. Put gas in there, no primer bulb or anything, pulled this on the first try and it's going to, and it started. So to start off with, we're going to be in mulching mode. I'm going to run a couple passes this way, four passes this way in the mulch mode, and we'll see how it does. Watch this thing start. So I'm sure you can tell from the video, we've been through spring and we're just getting into summer right now, so the grass is just a hair dry. and it's not growing very tall. I'm trying my hardest to cut as much off of this grass as I can, but you know, you go too low, you're gonna hurt your grass. But as far as it cutting and mulching, it's doing a fine job. As a matter of fact, I don't see any stragglers right offhand. If I got, yeah, I do. There's a couple. This was right in the middle of the mowing line. But along with that one is a freshly cut blade. Other than that, I'm not seeing too much. I'd really have to get down and analyze it to give you more. Oh, you know why it didn't cut right there? I didn't mow right there. I stopped back there and walked it up to the tree. So let's get this side plate off of here. Let's put a side discharge on it and see how that works. Overall, the cut quality on discharging, side discharging, is good. I'm not sure if the spots I'm seeing is spots that I've missed. I think that they're running a 22 inch mower and this one being a 21. I keep getting off of those lines. It's hard to follow. And I'm not cutting very much off the tops. So again, it's hard to follow my lines and see where I have or haven't cut. But overall, cut quality is still good. I love the personal pace on this still. Just hands down, one of the best systems out there. The motor is super quiet. I should have my earplugs in. Forgot those, but the motor is still super quiet. This isn't one of those loud two-stroke sounding engines. This is a four-stroke engine, so I really like the quietness of it. So, yeah, it mulched good. It discharged good. Now let's put it in the bag. All right, so to put the bagger on, reach in here, unlock this little silver piece, and pull the plug out. You take your bagger. The bagger's super easy to install. Just lay it in there. It's in there. Now that we're bagging, I'm going to run four stripes on here. I'm going to be able to reach into this bag and actually show you guys how good it's cutting. Get a better idea instead of looking at the ground, wondering if it cut, if it didn't cut. We can actually reach in here, grab grass out, diagnose it, see actually how good it's cutting. Let's get at that. It's clean. It's a fairly clean cut. All right, so let's get the bag off here and see how well these clippings are clipped. And as you can see, we did not cut much. The grass is not tall. As a matter of fact, it sucked up a lot of thatch. I can see all the brown. So it's got plenty of suction, enough to suck the thatch up that's down on the ground. Cut quality wise, there's old grass and there's a new cut right there. You can see the difference on the edges, how their mower is a little bit dull and this one's sharp cutting. Of course, it's a new mower, what do you expect? But as far as the clippings go, it's cutting, it's not chopping or slapping the grass. Look how fine that is.
As it blows in the wind.
Yeah, so those it's got some bumps underneath that deck to keep that grass bouncing around and getting chopped up really fine. And just to see how fine this actually cuts this up, let's just see how it does right here real quick. Now I did forget to put that back plate on there, so it spit out the back. But now that whole pile is just gone, other than what shot out the back. You know what? I'm gonna go cut a little bit taller grass just to double check the cut quality on this. All right, here on the side of the house, they've gotten a lot more standing water here and sunlight, so the grass is a little more healthy over here, so we're going to cut this over here, get a better idea of how this thing's actually cutting. So it cut it, and it cut it, you know, I could visually see that it was actually cutting it this time. The grass was taller, so you can see I was probably cutting off about that much, about an inch. Okay, now I did say that, maybe not in this video, these are sponsored videos by Toro, and I guarantee you will not find a false advertisement on my channel. I can't give this 100% on the cut quality. It's definitely good.
Before you say that, being the lawn maintenance business owner that I am,
yeah,
you need to take this to a different spot, maybe in your backyard, lower the deck to where you're at the crest for suction with the grass, because I can still see the lips on the side when you're cutting this, and I want to see if that makes a difference. Before you say what you're going to say, let's do one more test, and I want to make sure what I'm thinking is or isn't correct.
Thicker grass, higher lift.
Not necessarily thicker suction. Grass. You need to drop it down to where you're getting the suction. It's a little hot and you shouldn't be mowing that way.
You're right.
But let's do one more test before you say what you want to say, then I'll let you say what you want to say.
Okay, deal.
So this spot right here in your backyard has a little bit taller, thicker, I would call it even wet grass. You get moisture, you're shaded, it's not hot, it's not dried out, and your grass is up above the bottom plate for your mower to get suction. Now let's see if this changes things, because over there that grass really, in my opinion, didn't necessarily need to be cut, but this definitely does. Let's see if there's a difference. Let's side discharge so we can see the grass coming out.
All right, so we got the side discharge on there now. Just to show you guys the grass coming out, it's thicker. And mowing in a circle, I realize that you guys aren't going to be able to tell much, so I'm going to go back and forth just to make it more visible.
And I don't know if you guys can tell on camera, but a night and day difference. And I will let you go back into what you were saying. It's just, I mean, I got a little bit of experience for what I'm talking about.
Listen to the big dog. You need suction to mow grass properly. High lift blades.
Think of it this way. Like I try to explain it to some people, your vacuum cleaner. If you have your vacuum cleaner set too high, like it doesn't vacuum at all.
Yeah.
But when you have it squashed down to the carpet, it really pulls up vacuum. That's the same way a mower works. You got to treat your regular layer, not your really tall stuff, but your regular layer of grass. It's like your carpet. And that's pretty much where you want your mower deck at to get the right suction.
Yeah, I don't even need to continue on with that to tell you that that's a proper cut.
Yeah, that's a totally different than what was going on in that last property. Like I said, you can see it right here. From what he cut and what he didn't cut, this needed to be cut. That last yard really didn't need to be cut.
No, and I thought that they had nicer grass. They still have nice grass, but I thought that their grass was healthier than mine because mine is crap.
But you get the shade. But they're in the sun, it's hot, it's nasty. But yeah, that is how this mower performs, I would think, as long as you have it set correctly.
And how much are we cutting off?
Oh, you're a good inch or so. Well, that tall one don't count, but that's your average.
Well, 2 inches. My thumbs are an inch, so 2 inches.
Yeah.
2 inches off.
And 2 inches is okay, because you got to remember your rule of thumb is, I mean, I don't know how big anyone wants to get into it.
Yeah.
1/3 of the grass blade, and you got a good 4 inches of grass under there.
Yeah.
So you're cutting off about a third.
Did you get that down there?
Yep.
All the way up to, that's 4 inches there, so I cut.
Yeah, so you're cutting it 4 inches, and this is probably like 5 inches, 6 inches of grass. But yeah, that suction that you get on these mowers for the way they perform make a huge difference.
So yeah, cut quality is on par. It's acceptable, it's more than acceptable. It does what it does.
And this is why we give you honest reviews, because you could have just demolished this mower, but luckily I'm here to go, wait a minute, man, I'm telling you, you're not getting the suction that mower needs to perform. Because
right.
He wanted it tall because it's hot, which is a granted. I give it to him. But this mower needed to be another notch or two down to cut that last yard properly the way it needed to be cut.
Yeah. So, guys, like I say, we'll bring you the truth every time. Thanks for Handy for being here to pull Toro out of the ditch on that one.
Yeah. Because, like, even on this right now, you can see it on the side. You're getting a proper vacuum. It is flush with the bottom of the deck. Before that last one, you could see a gap underneath the mower like that. It needs to be like this to get that proper suction. So when you're losing that suction, you're not cutting grass.
So as you can see, proper grass height, proper mower height, all of that goes into play on how this thing is going to cut. You get good grass, a good height, and your mower at the right height, it's going to cut good. Again, thanks Andy for coming out and helping me out with this review. Thanks Toro for sending these products out for me to review. Guys, if you like any of this content, please leave a comment down below. Hit the subscribe button. Hit one of these corners up here for the Toro playlist for me. Run into all of the Toro equipment that they have. other than that, guys, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, leave a comment down below. I will see you in the next one. I'm out.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I just dream of fishing while I'm going through my workday. I listen to my boss, though he's driving me berserk. Damn it, I can't take much more because my brain is really hurting. And now the bank is always calling and I don't know what to do. And I haven't bought a crankbait since like 1992. But the bass are out there schooling.